Who doesn't love Diwali? Good food, new clothes, great weather, and the most famous viral pic of Diwali from NASA. But the question arises, why? Why do we make Rangoli during Diwali? Does lighting lamps during Diwali make any difference? Why do we eat whatever we eat during Diwali? Why is Diwali celebrated at different dates every year? Do we have an actual reason to celebrate Diwali? Or is there any reason behind it? Now let's find out the logic behind this magic. Number 1. Why do we light lamps or diyas during Diwali? Apart from the literal meaning of spreading light and symbolizing the victory of light over darkness, the lighting of these lamps has a scientific reason behind it. It is done so to ward off the most dangerous animal in the entire world. They are responsible for the death of half of the people who ever lived. This animal is mosquito. These mosquitoes are responsible for an estimated 1 million deaths per year. Since Diwali is celebrated just at the onset of winters, when the temperature and humidity are low, this results in creating a favorable condition for the rapid growth of these insects. So in a time when now famous mosquito repellents didn't exist, our ancestors used these lamps as a great source of warding away these insects just by using these natural ingredients in lighting a lamp that was as effective or even better and less harmful than today's mosquito repellents. Wasn't this ingenious of them? Want to know the secret ingredients to their eco-friendly mosquito repellent? Well, to be honest, there is no such secret. They just used a concoction of 5 ingredients for burning lamps specifically made from clay. The 5 oils they used are 1. Coconut oil, 2. Mahua oil, 3. Castor oil, 4. Neem oil, 5. This oil is known as the Panch Deepam oil, which, as I mentioned before, is a natural insect repellent with zero toxic fumes and side effects. Isn't it amazing how our ancestors used all the natural ingredients to create something so useful? Number 2. Why do we make Rangoli during Diwali? Well, we all love to look at a great piece of art, and what's better than colorful geometric art made in front of our house? Rangoli is said to represent the happiness, positivity, and liveliness of a household and is intended to welcome Lakshmi, the goddess of wealth and good luck. But apart from this, there are various scientific reasons for making a Rangoli. For instance, traditionally, either powdered calcite and limestone or cereal powders are used for the basic design. The limestone is capable of preventing insects from entering the household, and the cereal powders attract insects and keep them from entering the household. Once again, our ancestors found a way to keep insects away by using natural ingredients which are safe for everyone. Another reason for making Rangoli is a bit more scientific. Before explaining that, let's take 5 seconds to look at these beautiful traditional Rangoli. I have mentioned the links to the Instagram id and YouTube channel of the artists in the video description. Please do show your support to this beautiful art form of theirs, as they deserve all the appreciation in this world. So before coming back to the other scientific reason for creating Rangoli, let me ask one simple question to all of you. Do you all love good music? I know your instant answer, I know it's yes. But do you know what makes us love music? That is the scientific reason. Well, it's simple physics. Sound is actually made up of several harmonics, where each harmonic corresponds to a certain frequency. When the right harmonics are combined, we get pleasing sounds that soothe the mind and calms us. It becomes melodious music. Well, this exact concept is the second scientific reason for making Rangoli at the entrance of our houses. When a person looks at such a geometric pattern, it manifests into vibrations inside the mind of the observer, which in turn calms the mind. and this is exactly what Rangoli does to one's mind, i.e. it has a soothing effect. Scientists and doctors have extended it further and created a new medical field called cymotherapy, in which highly complex vibrations are converted into sound patterns, which in turn can be used to heal a person's body and emotions. Isn't it so extraordinary how our ancestors were able to identify this and incorporate it into their lifestyle? Number 3. The most important thing, food. Why do we eat all these snacks during Diwali? Once again, the answer comes down to the secret ingredient. This time there's only one, and that secret ingredient is none other than the wrongfully accused ghee. Yes, you heard it right, it's ghee. But doesn't eating ghee makes you put on weight? Well, it depends on how it's made and how much you consume. As we all know, moderation is the key. Pure ghee is considered the food of gods in Ayurveda. Did you know, even though ghee is derived from milk, it is lactose-free, resulting in no bloating for many lactose-intolerant people? This ghee acts as a catalyst that helps break down the nutrients from the food that we eat and provides essential fatty acids for our body. But the sad part is that we are blindfolded by this truth about the health benefits of ghee by the big refined oil companies to boost their sales. They have always targeted our traditional pure ghee as bad for our health and fattening. But there are various research that proves the other way around. Ghee also helps our body to get more energy and keep it warm during winters, which are just after Diwali. As I mentioned before, of course, however good a thing might be, it is very important to maintain moderation. Number 4. Why do we celebrate Diwali on different dates every year? Unlike New Year, Christmas, and other yearly celebrations, Diwali is not celebrated on one particular day, as the exact dates change each year and are determined by the position of the moon, but it usually falls between October and November, making Diwali even better, since we are depending on nature to tell us when exactly we should celebrate Diwali. Number 5. Why do we do a deep cleaning of our homes before Diwali? It is always believed that Diwali is the time when Goddess Lakshmi steps into our house, bringing wealth, peace and prosperity. So to make Lakshmi Puja more effective, we clean and decorate the house, because cleanliness is next to godliness. This is what we are told, but apart from this, what is the scientific reason to do a deep cleaning of our homes? One easy to understand reasoning behind this is that a clean home brings more positive energy to the people living within. But the other reason is that, since Diwali is celebrated somewhere between mid-October to mid-November, right after monsoon's end, the cleaning makes sure that all the germs and infestation that monsoons brought with it gets eradicated with the deep cleaning. Now, after looking at all these reasons, what do you think? Is there any logic behind all these ancient stories? There are various folklores that we are taught about Diwali from a young age. For instance, first, the return of Lord Rama with his wife Sita to Ayodhya along with his brother Laxmana after killing the demon King Ravana in Lanka. The people of Ayodhya decorated the streets and their homes with lamps to welcome Lord Rama. Second, Narakasura was killed by Lord Krishna. Before his death, Narakasura had a boon that his death should be a festive celebration. Third, rescue of Goddess Lakshmi. King Mahabali was a powerful ruler and defeated all gods and enslaved Goddess Lakshmi. Vimana, the fifth avatar of Vishnu, approached Mahabali and rescued Goddess Lakshmi from his captivity. Thus, on the third day of Diwali, Lakshmi is worshipped. You can know more details about King Mahabali and this story from my video on Onam. I will link to it at the end of this video. Fourth, return of Pandavas after their 13 years of exile. People who loved them welcomed them with the lamps. Whatever these stories may be, they have a reason, and we now know the scientific reason behind these practices. But once again, the question is, why stories? Why can't they just tell the scientific reason behind it? One reasoning for this that I can give is by quoting one of my favorite fictional characters. I started this channel to spread the knowledge that these stories are much more than traditional folklores. Instead, these stories are a great source of information for us and to our future generation on how to lead a happy and healthy life. At least just remember the most important reason for celebrating Diwali. Diwali celebrates the victory of good over evil, the victory of light over darkness, knowledge over ignorance. Just like we are ignorant about the various cultural aspects of our country. So this Diwali, can we pledge to make life better for these people in our country who are the most affected by COVID-19, the daily wage workers who sell handicrafts during Diwali, and we can act as the lamps to guide Goddess Lakshmi to their homes. We can buy at least one of their art, it may be lamps, idols of gods and goddesses, or any decorative item. Do you think the same? And if your answer is yes, share this idea with everyone. I won't say that you should share my video to spread this idea of helping these people, as it is way bigger than my likes and subscribers count. It is about the people. At last, thank you for watching this video. Be kind to everyone, stay safe and keep the planet safe.